Our next caller is Bailey from Texas.
Hey, Bailey, how can we help you?
Hey, guys. First, want to say thank you for everything you guys do. I transitioned from endurance training to resistance, and podcast has been super helpful. So thanks for everything.
Boom. We did it.
Thanks. I recently bought the summer bundle and starting the aesthetics program. So my question is, there's a lot of rest periods between sets and just a lot of time in the gym, which I get, but wondering if it will hinder my progress if I cut some of the time down, maybe in half or superset different muscle groups.
Yeah, it will. So the rest periods,
especially, by the way, somebody like you who was an endurance person before.
Yeah, I know this. Mm-hmm. I know this must be super hard, right? Because you're used to that kind of training, that kind of fatigue.
Go, go, go.
And you know, yeah. I would train clients like you a lot, and they would hate sitting there and resting. Why do I got to rest? I feel like I could do more. The rest period is part of the programming that is pushing the right type of adaptation. Now, supersets themselves aren't necessarily bad. Neither are shorter rest periods, but there's a time and a place. And you'll find those in the third phase of MAPS aesthetic. You're going to get all the supersets and short rest periods you could ever desire in phase three. But when you're in phase one and phase two, follow the program. Now, if you want to cut the rest periods a little bit, that's fine. So if it says 2 minutes or 3 minutes and you want to do it in a minute and a half or whatever, okay, but I would not go shorter than 1 minute. 1 minute is the shortest rest period that I would have anybody take if they're trying to build their metabolism, build strength, you know, sculpt their body. In any of the especially those first
otherwise
two phases.
We're getting into aerobics. I mean, we're getting real, you're flirting with that, and somebody who already has a, you know, background like you do in endurance, you're already got that adaptation really well. So you want to go the complete opposite. In fact, let you take 15 seconds off or whatever, I would actually rather see you drop an exercise. You know, maybe I don't know what program we're talking about, aesthetic right now.
Yeah,
maybe there's shrugs or calf raises in there that I will allow. I'd rather see you drop that off and
to
stick,
make the workout shorter.
Yeah, to make the work, like if it was a time thing, right? So if a client came to me and said, Adam, this thing is taking me an hour and 20 minutes if I follow the rest periods the way it is, and I just don't have that time. I need to get done by an hour or whatever. Can I speed it up? And I would say, no, I don't want you to speed it up. I would pick a couple exercises that maybe that person needs less of, and I would drop them off or drop a couple sets off of a couple exercises to save that bit. The rest periods are important to the adaptation that we're trying to achieve, like Sal said.
Okay, cool. That makes a lot of sense. I appreciate it.
Awesome. And congratulations for the transition. And now, what have you noticed real quick from moving from endurance to strength?
I'm hungry all the time.
Yeah. You know what? That's actually one of the best signs. That is a direct sign that your metabolism is kicking in and that your hormones are probably in a better position. You probably are noticing better sleep, increased libido, and of course, the way you look. I'm sure your body's starting to sculpt and shape.
For sure. Yeah, there's been a big change even just over like 2 months.
Wow. That's awesome. Well, congratulations. Great job.
Thanks. Appreciate all you guys do.
No problem.
Thank you.
Yeah. There's like a few clients I would say that were the hardest to train. Like one would be the ex-athlete who was like a hardcore athlete 10 years ago. And then they hire me and I'm trying to get them to not beat the crap out of themselves. Uh-huh. This is another tough one. The super endurance fanatic that goes in strength training, they just can't.
They can easily turn everything into endurance.
Yes.
Yeah, it just can get away. And yeah, it's really just pulling them back on their own tendencies and you know, likes, because it's one of those like things that's just, it's hardwired at a certain point if that's like what you really enjoy the most out of working out. So it's your job as a coach to really kind of keep presenting the value of rest periods and how the intent of that and why that's like appropriate in order to get your body to change the way you want.
Yeah, you know what skill came in handy? Well, I had to develop training these types of people was conversation skills, because I would literally, we're going to rest between sets, so we're going to have a great conversation.
You got to like keep them entertained, right?
Yes, because just resting is like, it was like torture.
I used to stopwatch this client. I mean, this is the aerobics, group X client, that loved classes and that like high energy, keep it moving type of training. And then they came to me and then we're doing a strength training phase. It's like, I would literally be like, you cannot go to the next set until this. And if they, and the thing you have to be ready for as a trainer when you hear back is like, oh, it's too easy. Okay, well then let's increase the load then, because mm-hmm. that is the idea of what we're trying to do right now. And they will continue to want to start earlier because they've just been training that way for so long.
Totally.